Just what you can tell, I know you haven't had much work since Monday, but what's just the team's mood, mindset coming off that game and heading into the rest of the schedule?
Well, I think they got their heads up. I thought we did some great, great things. Played hard. I've said that we wanted to get three things done, and that's to limit their transition points. I thought we did that, and control the boards, and we did a great job of that, and take care of the ball, and we did not do a good job of that. So I think we had 19 turnovers, and they scored, 16, 18 points. So that right there continues to be a little bit of our demise, but these kids are resilient. They're positive. They work hard. They know they work hard, and it's next day, next game, and next day. And so they're really focused on today and getting ready to play Ole Miss.
Coming off that kind of game, and you're playing a team that's got a losing streak, how much of a challenge is to make sure they kind of maintain that intensity they had Monday?
Yeah. Well, look, this team is look past anybody. I mean, we just don't, just because of how our season's been, and they'll be ready to play. They'll be ready to play. They're anxious to get back on the court, and they'll be ready to play.
Holly, with the turnovers, Bashara talked about she thought maybe part of that was chemistry, but she thinks she sees that getting better.
Yeah. I think chemistry as far as different groups playing together, probably. I think that what concerns me is the things we can control. The 3 seconds, we know we can only be in there 3 seconds. Getting the ball in bounds, we had 2 5-second calls, that's kind of ridiculous. So I think it's the things that we can control we got to get better at. Now, if we're attacking the basket and we're in a transition, trying to run a transition and we miss the pass, that's one thing. We're attacking the basket. And I'm a little bit okay with that. It's just the ones that we can control that we need to clean up.
Holly, is there anything more you might be able to do in the context of practice to try to help this situation, or you just pretty much exhausted everything?
Well, Dan, we just keep putting them in the situation where it's competitive. They got to take care of the ball. They're down, they're up. So we're just going to continue to do that and do it with different groups. We do it with every we've tried to mix up the groups, mix up the teams. So we're just going to continue to do that and hope it sinks in. I think the games that we have, the Vanderbilt game, we took care of the ball and we did some great things. We just got to carry it over and make sure we do the right things every game.
You guys shoot 26% from 3-point line this year. Other than just getting in the gym and practicing, is there anything that you feel?
Well, I think it's mental. I think that when you shoot and it's not going in and not going in, I think you need to find another shot to take. And scoring it, basketball and scoring is evolved around confidence. And if you're not confident and you're not shooting well, I think you get in the gym and you just do it repetition. It's like a golfer making a putt 1,000 times. I mean, you got to do it to where it comes natural and you're confident with it. So I think we just got to continue to get in the gym.
Regarding the tweets, you had communication with Delino or Diamond since?
The tweets are, it's, you know, parents are parents. And, every parent wants their kid to make every shot, shoot every shot, play every minute. And I get that. So I think it's just a parent wanting his daughter to just do everything and be everything. And I get that. That's what parents are supposed to do.
Has he spoken to you since that? I know he issued an apology on Twitter.
Yeah, we've spoken. Everything's fine. Like I said, I get it.
Any questions about the live paint game Thursday?
About the...
Or what were you going to ask?
Just, do you have any sense that she's describing? She didn't say anything about playing time the other night.
No, I've spent... Not at all. I've spent time with her, our team, everybody, and obviously everybody's disappointed, but, you know, we talk a lot about adversity and what we've been dealing with. It is what it is. We don't sit around and talk about... feel sorry for ourselves. We're dealing with some adversity and we got to hit it head on, and make it better. You know, it's part of basketball. It's part of life. We got to deal with things not going your way. And the way you do it is just go back to work and take one game at a time and one practice at a time, and you stay positive. That's the only thing I know to do, and that's what we're going to do. We're going to stay together and work hard and continue to do what we do. And I'm just going to put them in the best place or situation I know for them to win.
Do you think you're close to the point where you can be playing your best basketball heading into the postseason?
Oh, I think so. I think the last week we've played well. I mean, I think we've played good enough to win. We just didn't finish the deal, and I think we're getting better. Like Bashar said, we've played with a lot of different lineups, and kind of still, you know, this late in the game stage in our season, we're still getting used to each other. But we play hard, and I keep telling them, great things happen when you play hard and you give great effort. And I think you're seeing the result of that. I just think we just got to finish the deal.
What does the lip pink thing?
Gosh. Well, it's, you know, Nikki Caldwell and I started the Champions for Cause, and it's something that we're very passionate about. Obviously, we're raising awareness, but just getting the word, and it's amazing. I think the most valuable thing I've done and got out of all of this involvement with breast cancer is the people I've met and the resiliency and the fight and their attitude. It's unbelievable. You're dealing with, here I'm dealing with adversity with basketball, and they're dealing it with life, and they don't miss a beat. And so, if anything, I've learned to handle anything that's thrown at me, because what I'm dealing with is not a life or death situation, and they're dealing with their health, and it's just amazing their attitude and what it can do for people who are at that point and struggling with their life and their faith. It just is those two things I've gotten that put life in perspective, and you understand what's important in life and your health, and getting over a disease is obviously the most important thing to that person.